Good morning, everyone. So we are passing on to the next paper, that is the Ethology, Evolution and Zoo Geography. And here we'll be starting with zoo geography. So what is zoo geography? Zoo geography, it is a branch of biogeography which deals with the scientific study of distribution of animal life on the earth and the factors controlling it. Zoogeography derives its knowledge from several other branches of science such as geology, ecology, paleontology, evolution, and systematics. This discipline helps to understand various things like the causes, factors, and patterns of past and present distribution of animals, why the particular group of organisms were present in a particular area and not present in the other. And why this particular group of organisms like appeared during this particular period. So all these kinds of distribution of animals, like Camelidae were present only in particular island. And then slowly, when we move towards the present, we can see that this the distribution of camels, it spread over the other continents. But now it is present only in certain areas. So such kind of a pattern of behavior. The factors which control the distribution and all these things can be understood. The nature of ancient climates, land masses, land connections, barriers, continental drifts, island patterns, and geological changes can be understood. That is, we can see that when we study the past history of Earth, there have been ice ages. And between the ice ages and during the ice ages, what were the changes happening? What are the climatic patterns? And then the land masses, how these land masses separated in continental drifts, and what kind of which land masses remained together for a pretty long time, while the other it got separated earlier. And why certain regions do have a high amount of diversity, and such kind of changes can be studied, can be understood via zoogeography. Okay. Now the we can also understand the types of animal movement, dispersal, competition, and survival. It also helps to understand the causes of dominance of certain species at certain places, their subsequent disappearance and extinction, and finally replacement by the diverse groups. And more above all, a better understanding of the process of organic evolution, particularly of isolated species, can be understood. Okay. Isolated species means like those species which are found only in a specific area. It is not found nowhere else. Okay, so geographically it is isolated, right? So these are the things which we can understand. We can see it is a scope of zoo geography. Okay. Animal distribution on continents is highly complex, actually. How, why, and what are the factors controlling this animal distribution, it is to be studied. And hence, it is not always easy to explain why animals are distributed as they are. Since we can see, for example, Africa has elephants, antelopes, and great apes. And Brazil, which have the similar environmental conditions as Africa, doesn't have any of these animals. So why is it so? We don't know. That is what we have to we can understand through zoogeography. Okay. Again, like Great Britain and Japan, it is widely separated, isn't it now? But they possess similar fauna, right? Whereas so closely located regions like Bali and Lombok, they are small islands in the Malayan archipelago. They are separated only by about 15 miles. Okay. They have highly dissimilar animal composition. So why is it? Okay, these are being studied, or these are being explained through the studies of zoogeography. Fine. So this is what happens. Now, regarding the history of zoogeography, actually, much of the studies or full history of zoogeography has not been written. And this actually, the zoogeographical studies actually started since the beginning of voyages around the world. Okay, and as explorations expanded and became scientific, such information became an important source of the knowledge. And this is how the zoogeography was started, but a very scientific way of explaining these distributions were not written, and the literature was not available. So in 18th century, it was Buffon who held formal ideas about animal distribution. And in 19th century, important contributions were made by Haeckel, Ernst Haeckel, who was a German scholar, and he came up with a book on general zoology in 1866, where he made a zoogeographical approach in dealing with biological phenomena. And then we had in 1857, Dr. Sclater. He divided the world into six regions according to the distribution of birds. So that is actually zoogeography, isn't it? So it is where like distribution of birds were taken for dividing the geographical region. So here it is a zoogeographical, based on a zoogeographical study. And then it was Alfred Russel Wallace who made a major contribution to the field of zoogeography. Alfred Russel Wallace, he is the co-proponent of the theory of natural selection along with Charles Darwin. And Wallace is regarded as father of zoogeography. He actually collected information from his explorations in South America and Southeast Asia, mainly those regions like Indonesia and New Guinea. But the bulk came from a worldwide correspondence with other travelers and naturalists. The result was the Geographical Distribution of Animals, the book. It was published in 1876, and it's still actually it is a useful standard work in the field. And his findings reveal that the different parts of the world supported greatly different assemblages of organisms. And it was clear that these disparities in the geographical distribution of organisms had followed certain general principles. For example, continental regions have more or less uniform biota, but there would be great discontinuities among them. Okay, for example, regarding the marsupial mammals, okay, it is restricted to Australia and South America. So there had been a great discontinuity between the two places where they are found. So such kind of disparities was clear through these studies. Okay, then came what you call the book, The Theory of Iron Biogeography by Robert MacArthur and E.O. Wilson in 1967. And this particular, prior to this, the publication of this particular book, the field of biogeography was considered as a primarily historical and purely descriptive one. But MacArthur and Wilson changed this perception and showed that the species richness of an area could be predicted in terms of such factors as habitat area, immigration rate, extinction rate, etc. And this gave rise to an interest in island biogeography. And the application of island biogeography theory to habitat fragments spurred or increased the development of the fields of conservation biology and landscape biology. Okay, so here you can see the two books which made a major contribution to the field of zoogeography. That is the first one, The Geographical Distribution of Animals by Alfred Russel Wallace. And in the year 1876, and another book by Robert MacArthur and Edward O. Wilson, E.O. Wilson, The Theory of Island Biogeography. Okay, these were the two books which had a remarkable contribution in the field of zoogeography. Okay, fine. So we are actually referring to the basics of zoogeography in this particular presentation. We saw what is zoogeography. So what is zoogeography? It is actually the simple study of distribution of animal life on earth. Okay, so what kind of animals are found in which places, and why that particular those particular animal species are found in a particular area, why is it not found in the near neighboring area, and what are the factors which control the distribution, and when a particular species is found in an island, how the species reached that particular island. Because island means it is completely surrounded by oceans, isn't it? There are many what you call groups of organisms which cannot swim through water. So how does that particular species reach over there in the island, and how they flourished? Why some of the, for example, most of the animals living on Galapagos Islands or islands as such They're all bigger. Okay, why is that kind of a bigger sized animals are found on islands, and why the what you call very close species of the found on the nearby continents are smaller, and why such a variation, why such diversity? So all these are explained in zoo geography. Okay, and what are the what are the things which we can come to understand through the study of zoo geography, and who were the major proponents or who were the contributors to the field of zoo geography? So all these we have gone through in the particular presentation. Okay, fine. Thank you.